Hello everyone, we are back for another long video. I promise I'll stop doing this soon. However, today we're going to go to Ride the Tide. Ride the Tide is an event that Aetherite Plaza puts together every year. And back when it first started, I would take Elysium there to do something for the event. So Elysium, if you don't remember, is my old venue. And I would always make sure we go and had something to do in it. This year, it's just gonna be me, because I think this year and the last year, it was just me helping out on behalf of my venue. But this year, I'm not representing Elysium, I'm representing Hatsukoi. So we are going to see if we can make a better glam than the one we have now. And if not, we will just go on our way. So I did see the update that this room has now, where you can check out your glamour dresser stuff and the Amrar in one place. Like, this is just an excellent addition to the game. I'm not sure why this wasn't here a lot sooner, but it is here now. So it's 6 o'clock, well, 6:01, I'm already late. I am going to be helping with a contest today, so I'm going to probably do some commentary on that, and on this, by the time this video is out, it'll probably be the day after, or the day after that day. And the reason is because I don't want anybody to, like, watch and try to cheat or complain about anything. Personally, I'm doing this video on behalf of myself, and no one else is denying or giving me permission to do so. But, you know, I did think about streaming it. I just figured it'd be better this way. So, okay, let's see. I kind of like the Shisui set. I might just put that on, to be honest. Yeah. We'll mix it up a little bit this year. Usually I go in, like, you know, something else, but I think it's time for me to change, like, well, if I'm going to do that, I would rather it be on White Mage. So I'll make a new White Mage set. First, I need to go to White Mage. Okay, we'll make a new White Mage set. So we will unequip everything. It's not important to unequip every piece of your gear. It's something that I do for whatever reason, so just ignore that. I don't know why either. And I need to put on something, like, random still. I don't know why I just took everything off and expected it to be fine. Let's see. Do I wear this at all? This can place hold for today. We'll put that on. And we have placeholder legs we're gonna need. We can have this as our placeholder. You can glam over this, I'm pretty sure, but it's not that big a deal because I'll just turn it back. Nobody's ever gonna leave, like, these kind of pants like that. I could wear this though. Heaven stirred height, and then turn that back. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so gotta find this glamour. Pretty sure it's in the glamour dresser. But the contest starts around 30 minutes from now. And I mean, I'll definitely be there on time, so long as the game allows me to be. So, and I know it's probably not the smartest thing to be throwing this together now, but it's been a busy day, you know? Okay. Whisper fine. Da 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 da. Let's see. It wouldn't hurt to have a search bar though. You know, we get one step in the right direction, so I'm not gonna ask for too much. This is already a big deal. Okay, what am I? That's, I think, is what I'm looking for. No, it is not. I've already forgotten the name. It's Shisui. Don't forget the name. It's possible I just don't have it in here. And I put it somewhere else, but I'll give it one more good look. Let's try this. No, it wouldn't be in there. Maybe it's here somewhere. No, I actually don't see it there. Am I genuinely just forgetting? Oh, you know what it is? I know what it is. We can't use these because they're too low level. That's what it is. Oh well. Oh well. I'm not going to be able to wear that. So let's try to wear something else then. We're going to go back to our warrior. We're going to find alternative outfits. It's sad, but it's what we got to do. So let's cast the glamour on that. You're at 605, cutting it close. Okay. Glamour dresser me. And now we might as well just scroll to the bottom because all the like low level stuff is always on the next page, so. That's a bummer. It was gonna be really cute, I think. But we'll work with what we got. Exclusive? Nope. Even with this feature, I still can't find what I'm looking for when I actually want it. That's so crazy to me. Okay, so there's this one. I haven't worn that in a while. But there's also this one, which I think is going to be better for right now. So let's do that. And then we want to get a bottom that kind of matches something. Unless we stick with that. We don't have too many options right now. Not in that anyway. Glamour dresser, okay. Let's see what these are like. I don't really like those like that right now. And we could just... Well. I want to at least try to be in the, like, bathing suit of some kind. Spring bottoms aren't bad. I might do that this year. Okay. I'm just clicking on stuff now at this point. Alright, next pages. This isn't really a bathing suit, but you can kind of like play off of it, you know? Maybe the same with these. A little bit. Okay. So we might just be wearing the best choice already. Which is completely fine. I didn't, you know, have a ton of time to pick anything, so I'm not gonna get up in arms about it. Oh, no. I mean, this doesn't look terrible. It kind of matches. I just have to wonder if this is a better look. But hey. We will work with what we got. So, yeah, we'll just go like that. That's fine. This is fine. I think this color is pure, so we're going to want to pure dye that. All these bottoms. Well... Yeah, let's put the jeans on then. I don't want to spend a pure dye right now. It's no good. Not for like, you know, too sporadically anyway. And we'll just chill like that for now. Okay, so I'm sure my portrait for it now is just gonna look so weird. Where are we with Warrior? No, I kept the old one for now. I guess until I update it, it'll be that way. That's fine. So, let's head on over to Costa del Sol, where I will be meeting up with the people I'm supposed to be running this contest with. Now, I'm not going to show the contest rules, just because I don't want people to be looking at the rules and trying to cross-reference with what happens today. I think that'd be a little bit of a mess, so sorry about that. If you want to see the rules, you know, decide to be a judge next year. Can't argue with that, right? I was asked to judge for the last 2 years. And, I mean, honestly, I don't really mind. Like, I've done a lot of contests back with Elysium, so it comes pretty easily to me. So we already have a lot of people here. Let's get on a fun mount. I think we'll go with the fat cat right now. I just like the way it walks. It's a good mount. Not that walk, but this walk. This walk is good. Sarita actually got me the fat cat not too long ago. And I love it so much. So, I don't think I stopped thanking her for it for a little bit. So, I might want to look at the website here so I know where I'm going. Now, I will try to have, like, the website link in the description for when, you know, anybody next year or, like, curious about next year wants to go ahead and go there themselves or help out with the event next year. So, if you're not already going now, I'm sorry. You are a day or two too late at this point. But you have a head start for next time. And that's good, right? That's the important thing. So this year, it's Ride the Tide for a new boat. I like that they do, like, this cool name every year. And then, is We Ride Again on the website. That's fun. I quite like that. So, fashion contest? I think I'm a part of the fashion contest, so that is what I will be going towards. I just want to get a good idea of where it's going to be right now. So, if you look at this whole map here, and then I can cross-reference it with the website. Let's see. Interactive map. Oh, that's nice. This is new. Sorry I'm not showing the website. I would be, but again, it'll be in the description. So if you want to, like, reference it as I talk about it, you can do that. Okay, so we have music over there. And that's... okay. Uh-huh. Oh! Go-Go Fashion Contest. Okay. You're going to be all the way over there. That seems pretty far, but I guess they're using all of Costa del Sol this year. Most of the time, it was just kind of like they used parts of the island, and then I know there was one year they used parts of this, and then they used a little bit of another area. I think it was Morbi Docks, but then they added Island Sanctuary around there. So, if I am remembering that correctly, that seems to be why they're not doing that again this year. Completely understandable, though. Okay, let's see. Slowly going over to where I should be. So Elysium used to occupy this bar space back when we were doing it. And then over here we would do, like, basically this water game where you would try to swim away from the shark from this platform, all the way to that island over there. It was very fun. We called it the shark game, but I think we gave it a better name at some point. But yeah, that's what we would do. And then as time went on, we started like doing the contest. So already there's like a crazy amount of like concerts getting ready to pop off here. I think these people are already having a good time though. It's kind of creepy that they're all in sync, but I think that's just how the game does things. Oh. And they're playing Persona 5, so it makes sense why everybody's bumping to it. And the bars are like all the way in the back. There's no way I'm going to select them. That's neat. Oh, this guy is Sojido. Let's see what he's like. Oh my god. Well, I mean, he's got a fun profile. And since we're here, we'll check them and see why not. Okay, they're not doing too much of this. Anyway, let's go. So I'm looking for Jiaya. She runs the Inkwell, and she's been running the Inkwell for a very long time. So she leads our... There she is. She was basically a sister venue to us. Inkwell was, anyway. So sometimes she'll call on me to do some fun events with her. Ah, I should have wore those. Why didn't I think of that? This probably would have looked much better, too, now that I think about it. Well, okay. Maybe, actually, no. In black, it might still work. Yeah, I would have preferred that, I'm not gonna lie. It might just be too late to change it, though. Because now it's like, oh, I'm trying to copy her, I'm not. But okay. So she's doing some shouts for the event. Very cool. And we'll get our, like, fun dote. Yeah, I have a lot of hot bars, and they're a little bit of a mess, but bear with. Okay. So we'll wait here for now, and I'll check some things. Just to make sure everything's functioning. Okay. So we're back now, and I'm sorry about that. Hopefully there isn't going to be any lag in this video. I will do my best to avoid it, but I have not yet discovered what about Final Fantasy 14 slows down a video that I record. I've tried to fix it a few times, but considering those of you that may have saw my last stream, I think you know, like, yeah, it's a little rough, honestly. So right now she's just getting pictures of all the contestants, which is very cool. And we have some friends that we haven't seen in a while. Caster... And everyone else over here and over there. Oh, they noticed me. I should do that. I might want to keep my emote menu up today, to be honest. Okay. We need to get Bao up there. I'm going to probably need this the whole time. So, we'll stick it somewhere inoffensive, like, yeah, over here behind my character. That way it's not bothering anybody. Kind of like that. That's better for me, yeah. No, not really. Down here, it can sit here for now. I like checking adventure plates. It's one of my favorite things to do, so I'm just gonna poke around, see who we got here. There's some crazy ones in here, though. Kaikatsu Senshi. Wow, that is ridiculous. How could they? Okay, this person's strange. It's a nice picture. One player at a time, let me see. We gotta catch this guy. Okay. That's also crazy. It's probably gonna be a lot of editing for this one, considering things are progressing rather slowly. But again, this video will already take forever. So, there you go. Shorter form content. It's happening. And there is no stopping it. Toss a coin to your crafter. I like that one. I'm sure Chiaia's is still fun. Okay. Definitely questionable. So, Chiaia does this thing that I think is very clever for contest. She kind of takes pictures of the people and their glams long before we even, like, start. So we can just kind of start thinking about who the winner might be. It's a very good strategy. Personally, I wish I thought of that back when I used to run these kind of things. Because it would just save a lot of time, honestly. And a lot of people tend to sign up at the very last minute. Like, a contest will have no signups for, like, an entire month. And then, at the very last minute, you get, like, 40 people. It's crazy every time. Okay, let's see. The rules for this contest today. Obviously, no third-party tools. Let's see, what else? Costa Elegance is the theme for this year's contest. Which honestly sounds rather interesting to me. Because I have to wonder, how do you, like, portray Costa Elegance? Short presentation. Yep. So basically, you do a little short presentation. It's encouraged to do that and do like a little bit for 2 minutes or less, but it's not required. So, very important to understand. And then we have the first place prize, a full body art commission of your character. Second place is a choice of crafted housing skin. Or 5 million gil. And third place is a choice of 2 crafted glam items. Audience choice is 5 Ishgard restoration dies, which you get to pick which ones. Which is pretty cool. So, the prizes aren't bad. And the rules are pretty simple, and I think it's pretty interesting as well. Usually I think it's more simple than this, so I do like the idea of, okay, the theme's a little bit different. I have to represent elegance in some way. Some of these themes are very hard to do without clear instruction, though, I will say. It's getting dark pretty fast. We have a major general here. This is like the best minion in the game. This is a major deal, you know? Madame Sharkey. It's interesting for sure. I don't think people are allowed to have two outfits, but maybe. I didn't see it in the rules anyway. Anyway, I can talk a little bit about how Ride the Tide first started, since I was there at the beginning of everything. Before 8th Rite Plaza was like a fully thought out idea, it was just a gathering of a lot of venue owners, basically. And at some point, everybody kind of like decided, well, we're all very good at what we do, we all lead different venues and that sort of thing. So maybe we can, you know, put our different ideas together, do something a bit larger scale. And at the time, nobody really knew, like, how we were going to go about it, but it was very interesting because it was something different at the time. Back then, people were, like, very tribal with the kind of venues that they put together, and it was really hard to see people like kind of trying to combine ideas and not, you know, steal them from each other anyway. So, because a lot of people back then used to be worried about that, which looking at it now, you know, like it's a little silly, honestly. But now that things have changed so much, it's like, okay, today to see that this event came out of that is like, wow, like. And it's annual, and it's like, yeah, everybody had the right idea. There is just things that we all can do together that we wouldn't be able to do without. And that's basically what the community was built on. Obviously, as time went on, like, different things started to change how things were done, and different things improved. Some people left, some people stayed. But overall, I think the foundation of it and where it is today, it's in a very good place. So, essentially, that's what's brought us here today. Now, I probably already mentioned, but I will be judging today. So, I think there's two or three more judges. And my vote may or may not be, like, a big deal. Sometimes I have like a little bit different taste, and other times it's because I'm like looking at the rules and I'm like very strict about following the rules for some things, just because I've run so many, and I feel like most of the time, at least with contests in 14, the people that tend to win are always like the people that just bring the simplest idea, and you know, simple sometimes can be good, but it overshadows the person that really put effort into things. And I do want people to be represented for that effort, on top of it being accurate to whatever theme it is. And, you know, there are times where, like, you go to a Japanese event and somebody will, like, they'll wear a full set from Mug Station, or they'll try to, like, wear a Korean outfit, and you're like, yeah, I understand this looks great, but it's just off theme. And I want people that, you know, thought to stay on theme to be celebrated for paying a lot of attention to the rules and stuff like that. So maybe everyone feels differently about that, but I think it's important. I think it's important. And, you know, there's not, like, there has to be a rule for everything either, but if there are rules, you definitely want them to be respected in a way that everybody can appreciate, because then you start getting people that are, like, upset or annoyed, who feel like they did follow the rules properly, but they weren't, like, honored, and then somebody that broke the rules becomes the winner somehow, and I'm like, yeah, that's never a fun experience, at least to my knowledge. So I try to make it so that it's fair for everyone, and if somebody does look back at the event, they think to themselves, oh, well, okay, there's no way, like, I have an issue with this, like, this works, or this makes sense, you know? That is one crazy amount. Oh my. It's like a whole bison. I need to check my island sanctuary, to be honest. But okay, I'll probably be here for about an hour. But again, don't worry, I'm gonna edit. I won't make you all sit through this, I promise. This might be somebody I know and I'm just not realizing it. I'm not sure though. They just keep staring at me, and then it's funny because their message says, like, don't stare. Can you tell? Can you tell I'm burnt out for the day? So I've done a lot today. Oh, yeah, I could be using an umbrella. There's some kind of mount. I'm gonna go ahead and just, like, probably dope this person if they keep staring. Because I don't want to look like the person that doesn't know who their friend is. But if they're on an alt, it's like, how would I know, you know? How can I tell? Let me do some quick research to see if it is someone I know. Oh, it is. Oh, okay. Hold on. I can fix this. I just have to find out where they are. I'm gonna hit a clean dope. And then after that, I mean, no one can stop me, you know? And they have vanished. Okay, they're there. I got this. Boom. It's good. And hit it off with, like, a wave. Yeah. Okay. Just fine, just fine. I'm getting like a mount or something, maybe. Mm-hmm. No, that's not the right one. We got a fat cat. We gotta do it. It's a call to action. I know this. We all know this now. Now it's like, when do I stop staring? Right? I'm not sure. Are you still looking? Almost. Almost. No, they're still looking. I mean... eh. I might have failed this. I might have failed the test. Keep on keeping on. Walks forth. Okay. Where is he? Oh, okay. We're behind the contestants today. I see. That's a little bit weird. I guess it's probably not so bad since they're Lala, though. I thought it was like... okay. Walks forth with measured steps, a warm smile upon her face. It is an honor to partake of this fashion show. Thank you for this opportunity. My friends, I must admit I had to resist the urge to act as an impromptu lifeguard, and this showing is exactly the distraction I need. I count myself quite lucky to have such tropically colored notice just in case. Okay, I should probably have clap ready. Okay. So I'm probably going to do less reading of what they say during their performance since I need to respond here and there. So I'll try to be a little bit more mindful of that because I see Caster's already saying things. I haven't seen Zen say anything yet, so maybe I'm okay to stay quiet for most of it. But they're basically typing in yellow here, so that's how you know. And let me see who that was. That was our first contestant. Okay, their glam is not bad. It's pretty elegant. So, Madam Sharky here. Let's see what they do. And I'll just examine them. Okay, we examine. This is interesting. So they have, this is like a headpiece, I see. I'm not 100% sure where this comes from. Okay, so this is like, let's see, check here. Moonward Veil of Striking, I see. Okay, I'll have to take note of that, that's a good one. Yeah, see how fast the contest is going? Like, there's not much time for us to put in input. And it's basically because of how efficiently Chiaya runs it. It's just very to the point. Which honestly is good, because most of the time, contests like this take, like, anywhere from 3 to 4 hours. Depending on how organized the person running it is, right? Okay. So, we have her. I don't know why this person's on top of me, but... they might actually be, like, writing something on the spot. You have no idea. They look like they do some art as well. This person is an all-star as well. I guess they didn't have, like, anything to say ready to go. Which is fine. There doesn't need to be something to say. It's pretty hard to know when to clap. I think you're just clapping people start. Okay, what is that? It's Rathalos. There we go. This is good timing. Good timing. When you hear the double clap, you're doing a good job. Okay. My outfit isn't bad. Elegance is something that's very hard to represent in a beach-like setting, I feel like. Because it would be more about the personality of the person, less about the bathing suit. Sunglasses kind of sell it. Okay. Oh, I guess she's done. Okay. We'll go ahead and clap for her. Whoops, sorry, I just have this, like, giant menu up the whole time. Move by two. Oh, to the RTT comms. Oh, rather tired time. Huh. This glam, yeah, let me grab it so you guys can see it. So the question is going to become, is this piece elegant? I'm not really sure, to be honest. The hat definitely is close, though. So, another challenging one there. And they have their partner supporting them. Look, they have a cute picture. Oh, I see. Okay. Okay, we have our next person here. Bassett. This kind of... I think this would have worked really nicely if the colors were a little bit closer. Like if they dyed this bottom here. Maybe we get clapped there. Should smile first. Yeah, it claps on this side now, this is good. Okay. Okay, let me go ahead and open that. Thank you. candy, candy bonbon. A lot of people chose that top. And I guess this is kind of like the reality of like the swimsuit competition. It's like, yeah, representing elegance with it. It's just a real pain. I do like these pieces here. They're not doing too much because they're not like covering the whole leg. So I think this one has a lot of potential to win. But you know, it's gonna be up to the rest of our judges as well. And everybody's been in here already listing points of what they think of the glamours. Okay, so let me go check a little bit about that. I'm trying to make sure I like pay attention to both, so we get all the contestants like examined here for you guys. Okay, so 20 is the highest score we can give them. Which is fine. So I won't be listing any of the score points for anybody here. I'm okay with saying that 20 is the highest, just because, like, it's fine for you to know that, but again, for the privacy of the contest, I will be keeping all of that closed. Oh wow, this comment is crazy. It was good though. It's a funny call out to Chiayo. This character here, if you couldn't tell already. Okay, so I need to catch up and start giving points to people. So far we only had one withdrawal, which is good, I think. Yeah, so I would give that. Okay. They have been interesting, umbrella. So this person did think about their dye choices especially. I do appreciate that. And they even have accessories. I don't think accessories are on the rule list as a requirement, but I can respect the effort, honestly. Okay. And that was Tara. So we want Tara. I like that. I'll give her that. Not bad. Yeah. That's so sad. They would have won, probably. I was looking at some of the people that dropped out, and I'm like, okay. They might have done a great job there, but it's unfortunate that they, like, didn't go with it. Be generous about that one. There's another person that thought a lot about what they were doing. Oh, right. I need to examine her for you. Well, I already did this part. I think they put a lot of thought into that one. Okay. Who else am I missing? I need to go back and rank that person as well. sad because I didn't have time to clap because I'm too busy trying to score. It's crazy that, like, Chiara sets these people up pretty much on the spot, and then within, like, 5 to 10 minutes, they've, like, vanished. Oh, I see. If this person drops out, I can understand why, but... It's more like they came in basically just a normal bathing suit. So they might not have known about the theme, it seems like. Or they might have expected their character to do most of the work. Which is okay. It's just one of these things where, like, you know, this is your time to come up with a glam that you don't already have. Be, like, very unique about it. And it'll be challenging to rank, like, your normal attire against someone that's, like, really thought about what they're gonna do here today. But they could have had a performance that tried to carry them, you know? And from the list here, this is the last person, so... I'm gonna jot them down really quick. Okay, and I have scored all of my people. Very cool. Now we're doing a last call for the person that didn't come up before, just in case they still want to try. Which, I mean, you don't always have to go into a contest with the intention to win. You can just be there to have fun with it, you know? There's nothing wrong with that at all. Where art, though? That's fun. I believe this is Triaya's in-game RP husband. I could be wrong. I think I am wrong, actually. Ignore what I just said. That's not the truth. They looked similar, and I didn't see the name. That's what happened, okay? So, it seems the way we're going to do this here is between everybody's scores, we add them all up, and obviously the people who have the highest scores will, you know, take whatever win they deserve. Not supposed to do that. I thought she was just clapping at me. I didn't realize she wrote the entire message about me. And I'm like, ah. I was expecting this in the beginning. So, it's like now that it's coming now, I'm like, oh, that's way too late. It's crazy. It pays to pay attention the entire time, okay? That's what we're learning here today. Okay, she didn't ask me to say anything, so that's a lifesaver, because I think I erased the message I had prepared earlier, just in case. Blocking my screen. Pretty sure that's Leon. I'm sure they're having plenty of fun in the voice chat right now. I probably should have asked permission to just see if they didn't mind being in the video, but it was late notice. I wasn't even sure if I was going to record this. And maybe next year. I am also going to help with an event a couple of days from now as well, so perhaps I'll ask that person if I can do that for their event. And for that one, I'm going to be running the contest. Fun! A contest I just can't stop doing. I guess that's why everybody calls me for them, because they know, but I don't know. I never foresaw myself doing so many of these, to be quite honest. I think Elysium, we ran about, like, 6 of them, maybe? Well, 6 big ones, and then some small ones, perhaps. It's just a really easy idea to put together, especially when you have an event that's like a unique theme. Your next follow-up is like, hey, did you want to dress up for it? And that always leads into the, all right, this is how we're going to do it, you know? Okay. Looks like we have the final scores, and that is a bias score, Tyson. I think we all had like a similar like wavelength when we were thinking there. Okay. Right, you go in reverse, so they're doing third place first. Oh, that's crazy. Now wave is alright. We'll just deal with it as it comes. Candy, maybe candy ship. Well, let's see. Where are they? No, it's not me. They're actually gone. Well, she might just say what they get once and then move on, which is fine. I mean, I'm sure when they hear they've won something, they'll be back anyway. Candy did have a good one, though. I'm starting to wonder if they should win. It's okay, they got third place though. Still very good, still very good. Tara did a pretty good job. It's really the dye that brought their outfit together. Because of the way 14 is set up, it's a little sad, but there are certain items that just don't mesh well. But you can see the vision. Like, when you think about, okay, I see what this person was trying to do. And by them coloring it, it makes it a little bit more passable. You can kind of forgive, like, the difference in item and how they're, like, designed to be. And you're like, you know what? It's fine. I see what they were trying to do. Audience choice winner. So this is one that we haven't done a lot of. So I'm always curious to see, well, how is that gonna go? But let's see who they pick. Pyra, okay. I'm just curious about, like, what they got their score as. I see, okay. Not bad. Yeah, I can see that. I can see why the audience would root for them. They had a special good one. This fat cat's clipping into me. Okay. Better get one of the fun cheers ready. Like the jump. The jump one's always good. Where is? Okay, I'm a little lost, but there it is. Okay, cheer jump. Here we go. Yeah, there we go. Alright, now is the time. I think their presentation is what really won over the judges for that one. And, you know, like I say, presentation usually isn't, like, a part of the rules for a contest, but it being interesting definitely can make the difference, I will say that. Because, you know, everybody's here to kind of, like, be won over, compelled by something big, and it's like, yeah. That's the way to do it, you know? And it's not like they weren't on theme. They definitely were, so there's no worries on that front either. Just spins are doing, it's quite fun. Right, and then there's Mr. Costa de Sol that comes up every year as well. It's kind of like a beauty pageant, but I think it's a men exclusively. This emote is insane. You only see it every so often, right? Okay, and that might be the end of the contest. Let me just check and see if they still need me, and I will be on my way. So this event goes from 6 to 11, and right now we are at 7:33. I was only hoping with the contest today. Apparently there is the other one that is like the male pageant that's still going to be going on. I'm not going to be there for that, but I was told to last minute. Anyway, thank you for watching the video and all the crazy edits that came with it this time. I will catch you later.